In this video, I want us to define the notion of the function of an operator. Let's consider a Hermitian operator. Doesn't have to be Hermitian, but let it be Hermitian for simplicity. V, which, as we know, has a spectral decomposition, can be written as sum over I, VI, VI, VI. So for any Hermitian operator, there exists an orthonormal basis VI, such that the operator takes this form. Then the function of the operator f of the operator v hat is defined as sum over I f of vi vi vi. Well, in other words, in the eigenbasis, if the matrix of the operator V will be V1 dot 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 Vn, then the matrix of operator F of V will be F of V1 F of Vn. Zeros everywhere else. Right? If, however, a matrix is not diagonal, then we have to first diagonalize it, have to first present it in this form, and then we can calculate the function of the operator. As an example, let us consider the operator V, which is equal to 1, 1, 1, 1. Hermitian operator, and we want to find the exponent of this operator. Find e power I v hat. Let's begin with diagonalizing the operator, that is, finding its eigenvalues and eigenvectors. So one eigenvalue will be 2, and the eigenvector will be just this. Yeah, and the second eigenvalue, so this is V1, and second eigenvalue is V2 equal to 0, and the corresponding eigenvector 1 minus 1. Right? And once we found that, and you could have guessed it even before the calculation, I didn't show you the calculation of eigenvalues, but I'm sure you can do it on your own. But even before you did the calculation, you could actually tell that that V hat is equal to 2 plus plus. So indeed, this matrix can be obtained by multiplying this column by the same row, right? And the factor of 2 comes to compensate this 1 over square root of 2, right? So now we've diagonalized, and now we can immediately write that e power I V hat is equal to e power 2i plus plus. Is this correct? Actually, no, it's not correct, because look, in the V there is a second eigenvector that has zero eigenvalue, and therefore in the V it plays no role. But in the exponent, it will play a role, because the exponent of 0 is 1, right? And therefore it becomes physical, right? So we find e power iv is equal to e power 2i, 1 over 2, e power 2i 1, 1, 1, 1, plus, well again, 1 times 1 half, now have 1 minus 1, minus 1, 1. I can sum the two together to obtain something like 1 half e power 2i plus 1 plus 1 e power 2i minus 1 e power 2i minus 1 e power 2i plus 1. Yeah, that's my result. That's the exponent of this matrix. Now, there is one important property to remember about operator functions, in particular operator exponents, namely that for a Hermitian operator V, its complex exponent of the form e power I phi V, where phi is a real number, is unitary. And the proof is quite straightforward. Suppose V, the matrix of V in its eigenbasis will be V1, da da da, Vn. Right? Then e power I phi V hat in the eigenbasis will be e power I phi V1, da da da, e power I phi Vn. That is, all eigenvalues of this operator e power I phi V will be complex phases, meaning, well, that's property 5 of our unitary operators, meaning that the operator is unitary.